So what we know about the spread of this virus is it really requires either prolonged contact or close contact. So air conditioning is not really something to be concerned about. Where you should be concerned is if you have long and close contact with an individual who's infected. So one of the unfortunate things about this being a novel coronavirus is we've never had this before, so we can't really exactly predict. It will go on for a little while, and you can't expect that this is going to be over in a week or so. But what we're hoping to do is making sure that whilst we might be getting new corona cases in the background, this is not overwhelming the healthcare system. So actually, if this is a prolonged duration of an outbreak, it's much better than a short peak that then completely overwhelms the healthcare system. So this is really hard to predict. There has been modelling studies suggesting maybe April, but again, this is an ever-changing situation. And I know that's frustrating for people that we can't give definitive answers, but at the moment, what we just have to do is manage this day by day, stay up to date with the information, and at the moment, the best thing that you can do is practice social distancing. So there are a lot of researchers around the world working round the clock on this to try and reduce the severity of disease. So there are people who are working on new vaccines and trying to get those vaccines out as rapidly as possible. People who are doing trials with therapeutics, so either new drugs or repurposing other drugs to again try and protect those with severe disease. Then there's people trying to understand, can we predict things? Can we look at a patient's blood and look for a specific marker that then will determine if they go on to have a mild case of coronavirus or a severe case of coronavirus? So there's lots of things that we really need to answer, and we as a research community are working really hard to do that.